What's going on YouTube? On today's video, I'm going to show you what is the best startup class for Demon's Souls for the PlayStation 5. So we're going to start a new game. Yeah, play offline. We're going to do us female characters, fine. Alright, we're going to call this Helen of Troy. Okay. The best class is gonna be the royalty class, because it starts with a miracle spell, and her crown regenerates MP, which is what you use to cast all your magic. Alright, so the starting gift, we are going to choose the ring, which raises your item discovery. So we're gonna pick this. Let's see. Body type. Okay, animation. Kind of like that. Vocal. Yeah, that's fine. Gonna leave it at that. Appearances. Presets. Let's choose. Whoa. Oh, babe, what do you think about her with beer? Oh, man, that looks funny. All right, let's choose her. The customization piece in this game is crazy. I can't. She looks ugly, right? Oh, man. What's up, buddy?
That skin is crazy.
Right? All right, so that's going to be a startup class. royalty, the providential ring, that's what we're going to choose to find out in discovery a lot faster. And the foundation is going to be pretty much whatever it says in here. The appearance I just created, and we're going to finalize this.
King Alant the 12th, by channeling the power of souls.
No, we're going to play from the beginning, and hopefully we can actually finish the first boss.
Soul of the lost, withdrawn from its vessel.
Alright, so we are imprisoned in the Nexus. Alright, so the first thing we're going to do, we are going to go into Boletaria Castle, which is the first gate.
Thank you.
So once you pass the bridge, turn on the lever, and this will open the gate for the boss. You're still not done, so don't die. So, yeah. And that's the boss spear. Okay, let's continue down this path. Be careful, because there's some enemies in here too, to your right. See? There's another one right here. Okay, let's heal up. Okay, let's pick that up. What's in here? Okay, there's something here. Pine resin. That's to fight the boss. This felons, the boss is kind of weak to fire, so... Okay, let's continue. That's like a miniature of the like the boss that you're about to fight, so be sure not to die in this area, because otherwise it's gonna be a pain to go back in here, so try to be careful, take it as slow as possible. And Grass Moon, open the gate. All right, now you open all the shortcuts. And this is the fog gate. So, how many bombs we got? Let's see. So we have bombs, 12 bombs, and 9 pine resins. So that should be more than enough to kill this boss. All right, let's go. I know it seems like it's overwhelming, but just be patient. Let's thing drops shard stones too, by the way. So. Back to the Nexus. All right, so now that we're here on the Nexus, we can level up.
The monument.
Just repair our weapon. We need to pick a shield from this guy.
Come back alive. I need your business.
I'm stockpile top. When the Scud's my wife, but I would be worth. I would be happy to lighten your load. Rest assured, your goods are safe and sound.
The monumental. The monumental. Now it is your turn. You have you? Yes. I see. Just you must destroy the old one. Without you must lull the old. You must lull the old. What is it? Seek us out. I am... Perhaps... I was here when... What is it? Seek us out. Of course. Go. Let these vagabonds... Soul of the mind, key to life's ether. Soul of the lost, withdrawn from its vessel. Let strength be granted so the world might be mended. So the world might be mended. Art thou finished? May thy strength help the world be mended.
All right, once you go back to the Nexus and you talk to the Monumental, you can come to the Shrine of Storms and go to number Act 1. Alright, once you made it past all the skeletons, don't try to fight this guy, because he will one-shot you. So I'm gonna try to lure him out here, hopefully. I mean, if you can kill him, go for it. As you can see, he has a lot of health. He also drowns the Bladestone shards, and this is the weapon that you're looking for. And I'll show you why, alright? Remember, I have not leveled up anything, right? We can equip this. Right? And... this enemies become super easy. Becomes super easy to defeat. Alright, you could do two things once you're here. You can go and fight the Judicator through the shortcut. Hopefully it's still active. Let's take a look. Okay. Once you're here, actually, you go. Let's go and pick up the a key to unlock a cell. There we go. There's a trap down here, by the way, that shoots a bunch of arrows, and it can kill you, so just be careful. I guess they changed it.
Everyone's got crossbows out. I'm blind. It's who couldn't do with it. Nothing.
Mm. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that's how you become overpowered in Demon Souls in very early stages of the game. Let's take a look, see what we can do. All right, let's see if we can level up.
Then touch the soul of the mind, key to life's ether. Soul of the lost, withdrawn from its vessel. Let strength be granted so the world... Art thou finished? May thy strength help the world be mended.
Alright guys, now that we're back on the Nexus, I'm going to show you how easy it is the rest of the content. So I'm going to show you the power of the sword that you just picked up. So, one-handed, one shot. This is going to make your playthroughs a lot easier. See, everything is pretty much one shot. So, well, once you get to the higher levels, it's gonna be a little bit harder, but it makes it a lot easier when you play through the first playthrough in Demon's Souls. Anyway, guys, until the next video, stay safe, be well. See ya.